Hello everyone, I am Dr. Vidhyashri Kamath, Consultant Obstetrician, Gynaecologist and Laparoscopic Surgeon at KMC Hospitals, Mangalore. How do we diagnose pregnancy-induced hypertension? Most of the times, these patients will not have any symptoms. The only symptom would be an elevation in the blood pressure. That is why it is very important to go for regular antenatal visit, because it is easily picked up by a blood pressure recording by your treating obstetrician. There could be sudden increase in the weight gain, or there could be certain symptoms like headache, which does not go away even after taking a rest or taking a paracetamol tablet, nausea and vomiting, pain in the upper abdomen, swelling of the hands and face, or simply a feeling of being sick could be one of the symptoms. How do we treat and manage patients with PIH? Once a diagnosis of pregnancy-induced hypertension is made, we insist on frequent antenatal visit so as to keep a close watch on the mother as well as the baby. We do meticulous BP recordings, assess for proteinuria in the urine, do fundoscopy to look for eye changes. We do certain blood tests to assess the impairment to the vital organs like the kidney and the liver. Frequent scans to look for growth restriction of the baby, the fluid around the baby, and also to look for the impairment in the blood flow by means of Doppler scans. If the blood pressure recordings are high, we generally put them on antihypertensive medications. We may have to increase the dose if the BP is not under control. Certain general measures, we would tell our patients to avoid extra salt in their diet, like avoid papad, pickle and canned foods, and also to do regular physical activity. It could be a 30-minute walk or simple exercises, which will not only help reduce weight but also decrease the blood pressure. Specific treatment would be delivery, because it is pregnancy-induced hypertension, so delivering the mother, the potential complications can be kept to a bare minimum. Normally, if the BP is under control, the baby's weight is good enough and there are no derangement in the blood parameters, we aim at a vaginal delivery. But sometimes if the BP is uncontrollable and the baby is too small, then we may end up in an emergency cesarean section. Post delivery, the BP recordings will come back to normal. It could take few days to few weeks. Normally it takes around 6 to 12 weeks for the BP to come back to normal. But however, these patients in their successive pregnancy, they could have preeclampsia or pregnancy-induced hypertension in almost 10 to 25% of the cases. Chronic hypertensive patients may need to continue with their regular antihypertensive medication even post delivery. To conclude, I would say early diagnosis, close monitoring and prompt treatment will definitely prevent the complications of pregnancy-induced hypertension and will bring about a positive and an optimum maternal and fetal outcome.